Amen.
So the Lord is saying that comfort will come. The Holy Spirit will come. The Spirit of God will come. Give them comfort, give them power. 1 Thessalonians chapter 1. 1 Thessalonians chapter 1. Verse 5. 1 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 5.
As of the times and the seasons, verily, ye are holy that I write unto you.
1 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 5.
Paul and the Sicilians and Timotheus unto the church of the Thessalonians.
Chapter 1, verse 5.
For our gospel came not unto you in word only, but also in power, and in the Holy Ghost, and in much assurance, as ye know what manner of men we were among you for your sake. Amen.
And then, 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 4.
First Corinthians chapter 2, verse 4. And my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power.
Spirit and of power. The demonstration of the Spirit and of power. When you're preaching, as a preacher, you need the demonstration of the Spirit of power. The old preachers of 100 years ago called it the sacred anointing. There is a sacred anointing. God gives an anointing upon pastors and preachers and ministers of the word. And it's a sacred anointing. It comes with power and works in people's lives. How do you get the power? Humble
us.
You want the power? You be humble. You want the power? You be nothing. You want the power? Pray. Ask your people to pray. Well, there's a very, very special anointing for those who minister the word. A man who spends time in this book, praying over this book, and desiring to teach the people, spends time in the Lord and ask his people to pray, will be given the sacred anointing. And it's a power. These preachers that see people fall over the floor, nothing compares to the sacred anointing that a preacher is given. When he preaches the word of God faithfully, there is nothing like it in heaven or earth when a man of God preaches and the anointing comes down in power upon the church. When you look at the history of the church, there was no revival, most revival, 90.9% revival. Maybe one or two revivals without it. But 99.9% revivals come through the preaching of the word with the Spirit anointed preaching. The Holy Spirit comes down in power. So we preach the gospel, but we preach it with anointing. Don't get in the pulpit and not ask for the anointing. Don't let your pastors get up without your praying that they are anointing. That is the seal of your ministry. The seal that God has called you is to preach, is you will be given the anointing. Not everybody's called to preach. The pastors that said have the fivefold ministry. And they tell everybody can preach. Not everybody can preach. Those who are given the sacred anointing. Listen to those who have been given that anointing. Listen. You can hear the sound. It's an authentic sound. It's a power that comes down. So we finished now. So we're having a break now, or do you want me to continue? We have a break. Okay. So we close with prayer. We close this session with prayer. If we could close this session with prayer, is that okay?
I can close the session with prayer.
Hey, I